us and welcome to Vasili's Garden.
Today we're going out to meet Christopher, who's going to talk to us about his fruit trees and show us just how he does his own grafting. And Lady's going to talk to us about another smoothie that she's created herself. And Sandy Rogers is talking to us about constipation and how to treat it. Meanwhile, Jason's back at the garden and he's going to talk to us about hanging baskets. So sit back, relax and enjoy the show. Let's go meet Christopher.
Apparently, you grow trees. You like to grow fruit trees.
Yes, everything.
Everything. Yeah, but if you don't make fruit or food, you chop and take away.
Yeah.
How many children you got?
Yeah. I have
three. With this one?
Three.
With this one? Three? The other one?
One in Brisbane.
One in Brisbane.
Oh, you got one married in Brisbane?
In Brisbane.
So that's your other wife?
Sammy.
And this no, the other son.
The other son's in, so you got a son in Brisbane. Okay. And Sam's here. And your daughter, Maria. Pleasure.
Okay.
All right. Well, they've all grown up. They've got families of their own.
Yes.
You're enjoying it. You're making clothes for the grandchildren.
Thank you.
And you're also growing produce in the vegetable garden, which you share with the family.
Yes.
And Mama cooks it for everyone.
Yes.
Wonderful.
Of course, of
all right,
course.
Folks, sit back, relax.
Yes.
Because we're going for a tour around the garden. He's already off, ready to go.
Yes.
Let's go. All right, let's go.
Go.
See ya. What's this?
This is a seed.
Yeah?
This is seed.
This is one seed.
One seed.
I'm not sure if you can focus on that. Let's go in the sun there. Look at the little black dot. It looks like a grain of pepper.
And make million.
So this one will have probably 500,000 seeds here. Oh, why? You're going to get vlitter everywhere here.
Oh, what?
You like growing vlitter? We're looking at amaranth, folks. This is a plant that we call amaranth or vlitter.
Everybody is surprised when you see that there's these green doors and make this so
huge,
so big.
Yeah, it's a beautiful plant.
Yeah.
This is good for the fiber, good for the muscles, the skin, and everything.
Yeah.
Make you feel strong. Good for the chicken because it makes strong eggs. Nice, healthy eggs.
I like it.
You eat the chickens? You eat chicken?
Yeah, it's all right.
Yeah, you like chicken.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you grow this vlitter, but you collect the seeds. It's ready to go somewhere else. Okay.
Have a look.
Now you collect the seeds.
It's a million, isn't it?
Yeah, but do you change this one every year or is it the same plant?
No, it's grow alone.
Oh, by itself?
Yeah.
All the time?
Everywhere.
You feed it anything?
Yeah.
Food?
No.
You give it food?
It's grow alone.
By itself?
Because it's the seed that one, it's spread everywhere.
Yeah.
And after the next year,
it grow
alone.
Again, by itself?
Yeah, by itself.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
And don't need to do anything. How do you eat this one? Tell everybody how you eat this one. Fresh or steam it or boil it or cook it?
Oh, it's my wife is cooked with beans.
Steam? With beans?
Beans and with...
how do you say it in Greek? Fasolada?
Fasolada
with kukia, with broad beans?
Eat or vrazi,
lady
lemoni.
Ah, beautiful, that's it.
Excellent, beautiful. Yeah.
The wife is here, she wants to tell me. Come here. You tell me the recipe. Tell me.
You steam them or with broad beans?
Oh,
the dry broad beans? Yeah.
I'm imagining, you keep telling me more.
Yeah.
I'm hungry. Come on, broad beans? What else?
Broad beans,
olive oil.
Olive oil and lemon.
Lemon.
Beautiful.
Oh, you got some?
No, not today.
Yes, you have. Look at the plant.
The plant.
It takes about 3 minutes to steam.
Yeah,
olive oil in a cupboard?
Yes.
You got lemon tree?
Yes.
We fix it up for you? Thank you very much. Yeah. Well, there you go. Vlitter, grow some in your garden. If you got chooks, feed it to the chooks.
Yeah,
strong
right.
Eggs, beautiful yolk inside. Keeps you nice and strong with a fibrous diet.
It's come some very small pears.
Yeah.
You know, when it's ready.
Yeah.
Under that one, and say, and eat that one.
Very small birds.
Very, very small.
Yeah, because the bird understands where the good vitamins are. Nature's own vitamins. Where are we going?
Here.
So let's go to the front of the garden and have a look a bit. Not the actual front, at the top of the garden. We're at the front of the house here, folks. You can see he's on a hillside here, the highest point of the garden. Now we've just gone around the block and now we're going back down again. What's wrong with this?
The ether is a...
Oh, look at that.
Is a...
You got rats and possums.
Rats and possums.
There's holes all over that, folks. All the pomegranates, before they could even ripen, they've eaten out the insides.
I put this one.
Yeah, the
rat. Touch. It means that it's no rats.
Yeah. No,
isn't
it's
it?
A possum. You've got possums. Well, you're in a neighborhood with possums everywhere.
This one is ready.
This one's ready for eat. Look at this, hey? Pomegranate. I love pomegranate juice.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
It's a nice one.
This is a nice one?
Yes.
This is ripe?
Yeah.
Yep.
I taste it?
Yeah. Beautiful.
Mm. Oh, yeah. This is beautiful.
Yeah.
It's a nice fruit.
Now, how old is this tree?
15 years.
Approximately, eh?
15 years.
15 years.
What do you do with this one to grow? Anything special?
No.
Nothing.
You have to...
Just water.
Yes.
Sometimes
water
I put
when
some.
They want. They
when
need
you
water.
Need to. Yeah. And you just eat it like this, fresh, and you can make some jams out of this, a juice out of it.
Yeah.
Juice. That's excellent.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful tree. Nice. Now, with the possums, there's not much you can do.
No, I know.
They're in the neighborhood everywhere. They're going to eat your fruit all the time. If you can cover the tree carefully without making too much damage, good. Otherwise, pick them before they get them.
Yep.
Fingers crossed they don't get them all. Yep. See, we've got this one in time.
Yep.
So, nice.
Yep.
Get a pomegranate in your garden, folks. It's a great plant, great fruit, excellent for your... I'm not quite sure, but I think it'd be good for your blood.
I have the daughter of that one.
Yeah. You've got the daughter-in-law of this one.
I have one there near the...
Obviously, you kept it because she's producing. All right. They're all females, these ones. Yeah?
They're all females.
If they're males, we cut them out because they don't produce fruit. Now, we're heading back towards the back garden, folks. We've seen the pomegranate tree. Now, we're going to stop here because you got this bird netting here.
The Granny Smith.
Why you hide it? You knew I was coming.
Yeah.
Look at this apple tree. How good is this? Granny Smith. You have problems with the birds here?
Yeah. The roselle is coming in.
Come over here. Have a look at this. Come around.
And destroy it.
Here we are. They destroy the apple tree.
Yeah.
Nice. And you prune this? You cut this one yourself? You don't have problems cutting, pruning? You understand?
No, it's all right.
Yeah, I have to have a look. This is beautiful. You eat apple?
Yeah, beautiful. It's nice juicy, that this apple. You see, I read in the books, it's ready when it's come to start to come the leaves down.
Yellow. Go down or yellow?
Yellow, and then to fall down the...
Like this?
Yeah.
So this is ready?
Yeah.
Almost ready.
Yeah.
You got coddling moth, you got caterpillar here.
Yeah, you know.
But doesn't matter.
Yeah.
See that?
Doesn't matter.
That shows you, Chris no spray anything here. You no spray anything.
No.
You put no insect spray or anything like that?
No.
Just grow the tree. Do you have to do anything special for this tree? Because I see you got some straw.
Menu. I put menu.
What sort of manure?
Chicken or cow manure.
Yeah.
Sheep manure.
Yep.
Yeah.
And every, 3 months, 6 months?
Every six months.
Very good. Very good. Now, with the bird netting, folks, as we said before, when you do use bird netting, make sure it's nice and tight, not too loose or overlapping or free form, because the birds can get tangled up into it and it causes more damage to nature than it does protecting the tree itself. But in this case here, he's doing a good job, no problems. The fruit is wonderful. No insecticide sprays, because there are some coddling moth signs. A couple of caterpillars here and there, which you can just cut out, or if you enjoy protein, enjoy them with the apple. Include them in the apple pie.
Half the peeler and half for
Yeah, we share it.
Yes,
they're beautiful.
You know something, when I have fruit tree, never put any different, except the menu, you know, to fertilize it, you know.
Yeah.
Or complete fertilize.
Because if I put that one, it comes to the fruit, and after I eat, isn't it?
Yeah.
I use only natural things, menu.
Good.
Cow, sheep menu, or chicken.
Chicken.
Yeah.
Because if you use complete fertilizers, synthetic ones, chemicals, it comes to the fruit.
Of course.
And it comes into your mouth.
Into your mouth.
And you know that. And that's what we say.
I keep away from that one.
Good.
Yeah.
That's why you're 82 plus years old, fit, strong.
That is, I'm 84 years and I'm...
84. There you go.
I not take one tablet.
Not one?
No one.
You
tablet.
Want some? I got a bag.
No, sorry.
No, I don't have any bags, folks, or tablets. I don't take tablets either.
At the moment, I'm healthy. I'm all right.
Congratulations. A pleasure, mate. I wish you 100 years to go.
Thank you.
This is all because you look after your health and you eat properly and your beautiful wife.
I look after what I need, you know,
always. Yeah.
Yeah.
You don't buy it in a plastic bag.
And I never mix, you know, many things, you know, when I eat, you know.
Okay, simple,
simple
and clean.
Simple.
And clean.
Mediterranean system.
Oh, nice. Hungry. You want to get some glitter for me?
Garden to Kitchen, proudly brought to you by Cecil, Debco, Scottsburn, Casa and Bottega, and Renaissance Herbs.
Yesterday I put one in the scale, 480 grams.
The pear?
One.
One pear?
One pear. King size. Yeah.
There's some serious weight in these pears.
Look at
them. Wow.
Have a look. Have a look.
Look, it's loaded. These are beautiful.
Yeah.
Look how big they are. And this is the same thing. You feed it the same way. No different.
Yeah, no,
just manure.
No.
And it grows. I'm not going to eat the big one. That's too big. I'll tell you. I have to taste it. Yeah, you cook with this one?
I make a compost, as I see on the table before.
Oh, compost.
Yeah.
Oh, juice. Here it comes.
Have a look.
Have a look at this. When you said compost, I thought, what?
Oh, yeah, I know. A different one.
This is a preserve.
Yeah.
Now, what's with this? What's sugar,
just
water?
Just...
Or vinegar?
Sugar.
No, just a little bit of sugar. Not much.
Because it's sweet.
It's quick. Yeah. It's boiling. We put in the jar, you know, and boiling. It's come... Sterilized.
One sugar and three water.
So one cup sugar, three cup water.
One in three. One in three.
Sometimes I put more water.
And this keep forever?
A couple of years.
All right.
Sam love them, and all the kids love them.
In the morning with the breakfast.
I need a jackhammer.
We mix with the breakfast, that one, in the morning. The kids like that one. Excellent. Mm. Excellent. Yeah, I like it, huh? Yeah. Beautiful. Yeah.
You have your own teeth?
Yeah.
Look at that.
Yeah.
84, he's got his own teeth.
Yeah, it's my teeth.
I can't talk anymore, I'm too busy eating. I'm enjoying this, folks. This is beautiful.
It's good.
Yeah, smart, huh?
Yeah.
But it's healthy, folks, so this is the beautiful thing about it. Look at the smile! He's so proud of his produce.
I show you one thing.
What do you want to show me?
Here.
Look at the size of that cypress zucchini.
It's going another 1 feet longer.
Grows longer?
Longer, yeah.
It's going to be yellow, like the other one.
That's very big.
Very sweet. Oh, beautiful.
And easy. And this
different,
is...
Different taste from the others, yeah.
Okay, so you bring the seed for this one?
Yeah.
You bring the seed? Yes. Or you get it from here?
We
bring it from Cyprus.
Oh, you bring it?
Yeah.
Where'd you put the seed?
That was...
In the pocket?
Years ago.
Oh, 30 years ago.
Yeah, so you just put it in the pocket?
In the pocket,
No one cares.
I keep the seed. Even
okay.
They're asking for this sort of pumpkin, but because they're very good.
Yep.
I got the small one there.
Yeah.
It's a little bit yellow inside.
Yeah.
And it's different than the
your zucchini that you have here.
Yeah.
It's like a pumpkin more.
Yeah, yeah.
It's more sweet.
Yeah, and you make...
less seed. More
pumpkin.
Pumpkin.
The seed is only here.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know the bottom.
On the head.
On the head.
The seed is on the head. The other one is.
So the seeds. Yeah. The seed is only in the head part of the pumpkin where it connects to it, at the bottom part of it, and the rest of it is all flesh, like a pumpkin. Beautiful. Yeah. Middle of autumn here, folks, and we are still flowering with cucumbers.
Have a look.
Look at that. Yeah. It's full. Plenty of flowers. Yeah. Growing well. Are you giving it anything special now? Nothing.
Manure.
Yeah. Which is your favorite manure?
At the moment, I put the cow manure in that one.
You put the cow manure in the water. Come and show me.
Yeah. Oh, manure.
Now, this is your liquid fertilizing.
I put in the pot.
Yeah.
And the water.
Yeah.
Still
mix it up.
You know.
And then water it in. So you dilute the manure. You mix it with water and you put it around the plant. That's fantastic. And you do that how often?
When it's in the beginning. And after when it's coming to near to finish,
yeah,
I put another one,
yep,
and grow again.
Uh-huh.
And I go a couple times, you know.
Okay.
Every couple of weeks,
yeah,
you know?
Every couple of weeks, yeah, you have it and you do it around there. That's beautiful. And well, it's quite a simple process, isn't it?
I cut, before I cut it every day, 12, 16 cucumbers like that.
Like that
big one. 60 cucumbers every day.
From that plant there?
Yeah.
For a couple of plants you got there. He's done a great job.
Six
plants.
Yeah.
So a couple of cucumbers of each plant every day,
yeah,
for the last summertime period?
It was full up.
Yeah. Well, there you are. Keep it clean, keep it healthy, keep it organic, so you know that what you take out of the garden and share with the family, it's very healthy. What are you looking for?
Just to show you what's up here.
Show everybody. Tell me what's happened here.
This is the macadamia. The pulso, you see, is still is not ready. You see that one?
Yeah.
And the pulso come to eat all the
skin.
The skin outside. It drop down like that because it still is not ready.
So they're not ready. Now, if you cut this open, it's not ready?
It's not ready yet.
How do you know when the macadamia nut's ready?
Because it's full, the nuts inside, when it's ready, is full. Now it's half.
Well, you can tell.
Yeah,
how do you know? How do you know this is hot?
When you break it.
Ah, but how do you know to pick it from the tree when it's ready?
When it's ready, it's crack the...
Ah, the skin crack.
It's crack.
That's
the skin,
it.
And it's ready.
Okay, so the
now
skin...
Now it's not ready. The portion, it come the skin, it drop down like that, down.
And you got all these macadamia nuts on the floor.
Have a look.
Everywhere.
Everywhere.
What are you going to do? Mm. Can you eat them?
I broke any share.
Well, let's go break one. Let's have a look.
Yeah.
This is sad because macadamia is beautiful nuts.
Yeah.
We cut one open. How do you break it open? Like that?
No.
Yeah.
Special tools.
Yeah, these are strong tools.
Yeah,
I wish, huh? What about on a head?
No,
on a head either. Oh, this one crack. Wait.
Oh, no,
it doesn't crack open. Yeah. Not even a Pondian head can break it open.
No.
What tool have you got? You got a special tool?
A special tool, yes.
Yeah, you want to show me the tool?
Yes.
Let's go and have a look at the tool. I want to taste some macadamia.
So
you put the nuts in there.
Put the nuts there. And after this.
Wow.
It's
just cracked open.
Push like that.
Look at that, it's cracked it open. Beautiful. Oh, look at this. It is empty. It's not full. But still not bad.
Yeah, not bad because yeah, if it come on the tree,
mm-hmm,
it's come double size that one. Yeah, you see this one is come from Queensland, North Queensland. It's excellent, special. It's easy to grow. Yeah. Oh, look.
Nice fig tree.
It's the end now anyway.
Yeah. Look at this. We got figs.
This one is lovely.
Oh, no. You know what's happening to me today, folks? Apparently he had other grapevines growing here. Possums destroyed it. So now he's put a framework over the top of it to stop the possums getting in. And these are the new ones. How old is this plant now? How old?
2 or 3 years. 4 years.
Jeez, it's fast,
like that,
yeah?
Fabled that one. Because when it start,
yeah,
the possum eat the top one.
Yeah,
the
tips. Dry up.
It stops, you know, to
make
grow.
Make it more fruit.
More fruit.
It eats the tips of it so it doesn't grow any further. Have a look at the pumpkins hanging there. Oh, that's beautiful. That's what we're talking about. That's macadamia nuts. Now, they're not ripe, folks. They need to dry out. They need to grow a bit more and split open, like the one you just showed me before. Come and have a look at this one over there. There's one lonely macadamia nut there.
Is the last year, you see that?
That's from last year. Yeah?
Just.
I'm a midget.
That's it.
Okay. That's as ripe as it gets.
Yeah.
This is ready, huh?
That one is ready.
I'll crack this one open after. I put it in my pocket.
Yeah.
Like this. Pocket. See? This is my little nut. And we taste it after. Where you got, eh?
Outside in the garden. In the park.
You got more garden?
Yeah. Have a look at the nuts. You see what's happening?
Macadamia nuts falling out on the pathway here.
Have a look.
This is what the possums are doing.
Yeah.
They're eating everything.
He's destroyed everything.
Yeah, but you've opened them up before. They're still edible, but not enough, huh? You like them bigger?
Yeah, I like them bigger, and they will be put inside you.
You got an olive tree?
And there are...
More olives. And a fig tree over there, too. Look at the fruit up there. Oh, all right. We've had everything. We haven't had the mulberry branch yet. We can get this one here. Nice.
It's full vitamins, I don't.
Oh, I'm full of vitamins,
yeah.
All right.
Oh, yeah, it's really actually healthy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Cracks it open, all right. Oh, you just push it like that. Comes out. Much bigger. I crushed it, yeah.
I told you.
Look at
you
that, see? It's twice the size.
Yeah. Beautiful. Excellent.
Oh, now you can taste the what, the flavour.
Different taste.
Stronger flavour. Oh. All right, so you've got some wild canes that have come up from the base of this standard rose.
Yeah, the first one.
What do you do?
You find the...
The bud, the stem. Okay, that's the stem there. They're taking this bud off here. You're gonna slice it off.
Take it, yes. Make it up.
Did you see that sample there? Yeah. That's the bud, that's the part that's gonna be growing.
You make the skin like that. You cut a little bit up.
Yeah. So you take it off completely.
That one.
And lift off.
They
so put, the bottom part just sticks out a bit.
This one.
Underneath.
Underneath, yeah. To hold up, that's it. That's it.
That's
and,
it.
And tight it.
Gosh. All right, have a look at that.
Skin.
Skin by skins.
90% success.
90 or 99? No, 99. Maybe 99 and a half, 0.5, 6, 7, 8.
Success like that.
And a bit of tape. Okay. It's when you're actually wrapping the budding tape, you've got to leave the bud.
You leave that one outside.
That's right. You have to leave it out, otherwise they're not going to grow.
Of course.
You'll break it off.
Yeah.
Too easy. You do the same with the fruit trees, the same.
The same.
Everything.
The same.
All right, that's fantastic. A nice feast here, folks. We're going to enjoy some beautiful, fresh, home-style cooking with salads, pasticho, patatas, okra. Everybody's gonna eat, and the kids love it too. It doesn't get any better than this, folks. Beautiful, fresh, home-style cooking with lots of produce that's come straight out of the garden. Hey, everybody, honestly, what do we say? Maresi. Let's enjoy. We've come to the end of another great show, folks, out here in Doncaster East. We've had a great day. We've checked out the beautiful garden. Now, it's all about growing it yourself, avoiding the chemicals so that you can feed the beautiful children in the family, just as we have today. You saw the Barbie going. Now it's time for that moment. We're going to do the big Zorba. Yeah, where is it? Week.
Today what we're going to do is talk about arthritis. Oh, damn.
Extra water during the summer months while it's rapidly growing, but again, and again, and again, and again, and again, sorry, again, and again, and again, as you can see, and again, and again, and again, again, and again, and again, again, and again, and again.
Whoa, look at his nuts.
Like
he's got his nuts hanging everywhere.
He's coming.
Go have a look at that. There you go. Beautiful stuff. Now, they're not ripe, folks. Oh, the cameraman's just fallen over. Nice autumn day, folks. About 25 degrees out there. Gotcha.
It is packed full of vitamin C, and if we...
Did you get the side shot?
And if you were to have this every day, you would have beautiful, smooth complexion of skin. Now, first what we do is we need to cut up the under...
excuse me.
You right
there, mate? Boy. Oh, good. Oh, that was a weak one. This would be one big shice piece. Too late in the day. Help me, sir.
Vasili's Garden to Kitchen, proudly brought to you by Cecil, Debco, Scottsburn, Casa and Bottega, and Renaissance Herbs.